Let us now analyze the diffraction of light by a single slit. Here you can see the enlarged view of a single slit, which is having a slit width B, on which a parallel beam of light incident, and the part of wavefront of the light which is of the size of slit width will only pass on. And say here we divide the wavefront into wavelets as 1, 2, 3 up to n. We consider there are n wavelets, and the separation between two adjoining wavelets we consider as d. So here, as there are n wavelets, we can write n minus 1 d is equal to the slit width b. Now, in a specific direction at an angle theta from the direction of incident light, if we consider all the light waves which are going parallel from all the wavelets, then these all light waves will interfere at a very far away distance from the slit. Now, if we analyze the resulting intensity of interference due to all these waves, we need to first analyze the phase difference between the adjoining wavelets, and correspondingly we need to calculate the resulting intensity. Let's do the same. In this situation here, we can write in direction theta from the direction of incident light, path difference between waves from wavelets 1 and 2 is. Here, if we just talk about these two wavelets 1 and 2, I again draw the enlarged view of the situation. This is wavelet 1, this is wavelet 2. And if the separation between the two is d, and we are talking about a direction in which the waves from 1 and 2 are going at an angle theta, then the path difference between 1 and 2 can be directly given as d sine theta. If this angle is theta, this is theta, if this is the separation, the wave from wavelet 2 is traveling d sine theta extra path compared to 1. So the path difference between wavelet 1 and 2 is d sine theta. And correspondingly, we can find out the phase difference between wavelets 1 and 2. The waves in wavelet 1 and 2 in the direction of theta is equals to 2 pi by lambda multiplied by the path difference, that is d sine theta. Now, similarly, we talk about the wavelets 1 and 3. Correspondingly, here we can see between the waves emitted from wavelet 1 and from wavelet 3, the total path difference will be twice that between 1 and 2. So, delta between 1 and 3 we can write, it will be 2d sine theta, and that can be written as pi 1 2 is 2 pi by lambda multiplied by 2d sine theta. So, here if this angle is pi, this can be written as 2 phi, and so on. Correspondingly, up to nth wavelet we can take up, the path difference will be equals to, between 1 and nth wavelet, the path difference will be n minus 1d sine theta, and corresponding phase difference will be n minus 1 phi. So, now we can write, if displacement produced by wavelets 1, 2, 3 up to n, at large distance from slit are y1, y2, y3 and so on up to yn, then we can write here, if y1, which is a displacement due to the wavelet 1, it can be written as a sine of omega t. Then correspondingly, the displacement due to wavelet 2 can be written as y2 is equals to a sine of omega t minus phi, because the wave from wavelet 2 is lagging in phase by an angle phi with respect to 1. Similarly, y3 is equals to a sine of omega t minus 2 phi, and so on we can write for all these. And here we are taking a is the amplitude due to each wavelet at a far away distance from the slit. Let's continue the same analysis on the next sheet. Now, if we find out the resulting displacement due to superposition of all waves in direction theta is this y we can write as y1 plus y2 plus and so on up to yn. If we substitute the values here, we are getting y is a sine of omega t plus this a sine of omega t minus phi. Then it is a sine of omega t minus 2 phi plus up to this a sine of omega t plus n minus 1 phi. This is the value we are getting, and on simplifying the series, we are getting the resultant displacement is equals to this a sine of n phi by 2. You might have studied this summation of series, trigonometric series in your mathematics. Is a sine of n phi by 2 upon sine of phi by 2, as there are n terms, multiplied by sine of omega t minus n minus 1 phi by 2. Now, in this situation, this expression can be written as yr is equals to r sine of omega t minus theta. And that is at a very large distance from slit. This is what we have already discussed. And in this situation here, this r is the amplitude of resulting oscillation at far away distance, which is at same frequency omega. And here we can write now resulting intensity is, this resulting intensity we can write as k r square. If we substitute the value of r over here, this will be k, the value of r we have taken as a sine of n phi by 2 by sine of phi by 2 whole square. Now, in this situation, we can also see one thing here. If we multiply this term by n square divided by n square, then by taking this n square inside, we are getting the resulting intensity is k. Here we can write Na sine of n phi by 2 divided by sine phi by 2, we can write as phi by 2, as the phi will be very small. And here the value of phi we have seen, this was 2 pi by lambda into d sine theta, we already seen on the previous sheet. So this is sine phi by 2 is phi by 2, so this will be n phi by 2 whole square. Here Na can be written as the amplitude of wave due to all the secondary wavelets which are producing interference at far away distance. So k times Na whole square can be written as the intensity of the incident light. So this can be written as k times Na whole square, we can write as I naught, and sine square n phi by 2 by n phi by 2, this we can write as sine square beta by beta square. And here the value of beta we can write as n by 2 phi, where the value of phi was 2 pi by lambda into d sine theta. So here this 2 gets cancelled out, and the value of beta we are getting is pi n d by lambda. Here we already seen that the slit width, we have written b is equals to n minus 1 times d, where n is very very greater than 1 because number of secondary sources are very large in quantity. So here b can be approximately written as nd because 1 is negligible here. So this nd I can write as the slit width. This can be written as pi b sine theta by lambda. This is the value of beta in this expression. So, on substituting beta, this is the expression we are getting is the resulting intensity as a function of theta, which we were talking in the previous section. That is the intensity at far away distance from the slit due to diffraction of light in different directions beyond the rectilinear propagation of light. So, here you can see interference is nothing. It is just the diffraction is nothing. It is just the interference due to several waves which are there in the incident lights due to secondary wavelets. So diffraction is a specific case of integration of many sources in the light itself.